I've purchased a new watch, but this isn't like other watches. This is a Wi-Fi de-author watch. Allows me to attack Wi-Fi networks. As always with these kinds of devices, only attack networks that you have permission to attack or that you own. In this example, I've got a phone and a laptop connected to a Wi-Fi network. I can access the internet on this phone. I'll also start a continuous ping on this laptop, and hopefully you can see that this laptop is able to ping google.com. But what happens when I start the deauth attack? So I'll press start. Packets are now being sent into the network, deauthing clients. And what you should see is the laptop can no longer ping google.com. I have deauthed this laptop from the Wi-Fi network. On the phone, try and go to YouTube. It's failing because the device has been kicked off the Wi-Fi network. If I go and look at my Wi-Fi settings and try and connect to my Wi-Fi network, it says connection failed. Try and do that again. Connection failed. Devices are no longer able to access the internet because deauth packets are being sent from the watch to the Wi-Fi access point. This little access point right over here, kicking clients off the network. Okay, I'll stop the deauth attack. And what you should notice, hopefully, is that pings start succeeding on the laptop. And there you go. And if I connect back to the Wi-Fi network, I'm able to do that. I'm connected now. And I should be able to go to youtube.com, which I can. Under SSIDs, you can specify the clone of access points. So you can see I'm cloning a whole bunch here. Or you could go with, say, random mode to create a bunch of random access points. So I'll go back again. Deny access, beacons, and start. And what I'll do here is look at the different Wi-Fi networks, and you can see a bunch of fake Wi-Fi networks exist. You could use Rickroll names here. One caveat with this watch is it only supports 2.4 gigahertz and not 5 gigahertz, but it's a fantastic little device for testing and demonstration purposes. Now, this is called the Wi-Fi Commander, not a Wi-Fi deauthor. Even though it supports deauth attacks and other types of attacks, this is very similar once again to this watch that I've demonstrated. And that's very similar to the Wi-Fi Nugget as well as the Meltronics deauthor. Now we're told that it's got a 1.5 inch OLED display. It's got a digital crown control. Now this was made in England, which is interesting. Not that much stuff is made in England these days. It's a trademark of Code Junkies. Once again, I purchased this. They are not sponsoring this video. They don't know that I'm even making this video. That's enough talking. Let's unbox this. Not great packaging, if you like, very basic. So I got this from Amazon. So what we get is the watch and a cable. That's it. So that's the unboxing experience. Nothing fancy, but it definitely looks more like a watch than this does. It's got a rubber strap here. The strap isn't as nice. I mean, that doesn't look like a watch. This does. So what's interesting is this didn't come with any instructions, no instructions at all. But again, that looks much more like a watch than what this thing does. But the proof of the pudding is, can it actually do what they say it can? Now, there are some issues with this device. I found that the battery doesn't last that long. I probably need to charge it for longer before I continue with the demonstrations. Also, the one that I got, the charger is covered here. So the only way to charge this is to pop it out of the watch. And I saw on Amazon, the reviews are quite bad because people have found that it's broken when they've popped it out or popped it back in. But that hasn't been my experience. So what you've got to do is you've got to use a micro USB cable. One is supplied with the watch and now it works. As you can see, it's powered up properly now. So you could just use it like this, but obviously it makes more sense to use this as a watch. But you could just hold it like this in your palm of your hand as an example.
The power of the sun in the palm of my hand.
And attack networks in the same way. I mean, that's a very small device that could be hidden in your hand. This is basically a better version of the previous watch that I've demonstrated. Lot smaller, looks more like a watch than this thing does. Remember, the caveat with this is it only supports 2.4 gigahertz. That is made clear on the box. Only 2.4 gigahertz is supported. Okay, once you turn the watch on, we can see that this is authorized by Spacehorn, hardware by Code Junkies. When it boots up, you're probably going to want to scan for Wi-Fi networks, and you can scan for either access points or stations themselves. I'm going to scan for both. Now, I have found that this doesn't always work. The display shows that there are zero access points, even though it's actually picking up access points. As you can see here, it's picked up one station, but again, that information is incorrect. And I've found that it freezes here. So I'm going to simply press the button again. I'm going to go back and then I'm going to select an access point. So select and then access points. I'm going to select the access point that we're going to attack, which is the TP-Link 2.4 gigahertz. That's this little TP-Link right over here. Again, only ever attack networks that you own or have permission to attack. So I'm going to select that and I'm going to go back and back again. And now we can deny access. So select that option. And let's say as an example, specify deauth and then start deauthing. And what you'll notice over here is pings are now timing out. So this device can no longer access the internet. So on the phone, I'll press go. Notice no internet is available. So we have successfully deauthed the network. You can see that we're sending packets, but if I stop that, we should see is on the Windows computer, pings should start working again, which they do. So deauth attack has now been stopped. So it's as simple as that once again to launch a deauth attack using this watch. Really cool that it's so much smaller than the previous generations that I've demonstrated. Just looks like a standard sports watch as an example. Now another option here is to send beacons. I'll select beacons and then I'll scroll down and start the attack. So beacons are being sent out into the network now. Now this can be used to fake the real network or just spam the air with a bunch of fake networks. So as an example, if I go to Wi-Fi and look at the Wi-Fi networks, notice I'm suddenly seeing a whole bunch of TP-Link networks, many of them. These are all fake networks. So I'll stop that attack and go back. The reason I was able to do that is under SSIDs, you can specify the clone of access points. So you can see I'm cloning a whole bunch here. Or you could go with, say, random mode to create a bunch of random access points. So I'll go back, back again, deny access, beacons, and start. And what I'll do here is look at the different Wi-Fi networks, and you can see a bunch of fake Wi-Fi networks exist. You could use Rickroll names here. But as you can see, a whole bunch of random SSIDs are now being broadcast by the watch. Now, various other options are also supported. So I can go back and then I could do a packet monitor as an example and monitor packets in the network so I can see what's going on. Now, one of the options with the watch is you can actually connect to it remotely. So I'm going to select the ping SSID. We're told that this is an open network. I'm okay with that. So I'm going to connect to the open network called ping. So I'm now connected to that network and in my browser, so I'm going to browse to 192.168.4.1. And as you can see, a web page is opened. We're told that this project is a proof of concept for testing and educational purposes only. The watch uses an ESP8266. So we warned that the ESP8266 chip and the SDK are not built for real world purposes. They're only built for testing and education purposes. And bugs can occur. And we're told to only use this against our own networks and devices, which I'm doing. So you can get more information on GitHub. Once again, Space Hun or Space Chicken, if you use the English translation, has more information on his website. And I said I've read the notice. And what I'll do here is click reload. And that shows me the various Wi-Fi networks. So I can see the encryption used. I can see the MAC address. I can see the power, whole bunch of information about Wi-Fi networks. I can also see client devices. So if I go to SSIDs, I could clone an SSID or add one, and I could enable random mode. So at the moment, clicking reload, a bunch of them are random. So a whole bunch of random SSIDs, I'll remove those and click reload. Now again, you could add your own SSIDs here and do a Rickroll SSID as an example. So under deny, we could start a deauth attack. We could start a beacon attack. We could start probing. They also give us a nice explanation of what each does. So beacon packets are used to advertise access points. Deauth, I've demonstrated, where we knock clients off a network. And probes are sent by client devices to ask if a known network is nearby. You can use this attack to confuse Wi-Fi trackers by asking for networks that you specified in the SSID list. I could go to settings and reboot the device as an example. Or reset it. Now I've put links below to Space Hun's GitHub page where you can get a lot of information about the ESP8266 author that he created. Fantastic project. He gives you information about how it works. I've also put a link to Amazon where I bought this. You can see the ratings here are terrible, but there is an overview of the device on Amazon and you can have a look at their website to get more information. Again, I think it's a great little tool for demonstration purposes. It only supports 2.4 gigahertz, however. Doesn't always work with modern access points, even when they use 2.4 gigahertz. So if you want to stop kids using devices like this from pranking you or destroying your Wi-Fi network, or you want to stop hackers that have more powerful devices that can do something similar, use WPA3 with a strong password, not just numbers, but mixed characters, uppercase, lowercase, special characters, etc. Make the password long. Use WPA version 3. Use 5 gigahertz, use 6 gigahertz. Hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please consider liking it. Please consider subscribing to my YouTube channel and clicking on the bell to get notifications. I'm David Bumble, and I want to wish you all the very best.